Hello, good evening or depending on where you are, good morning, good afternoon. Welcome to this machine learning webinar. Today we are going to let wage a war between the most common machine learning algorithms, deep learning and gradient boosting machines, or shortly GBM. Let me introduce myself first. This is Shefik. I have been working for a fintech company as a software developer since 2010, and I received my master's degree in computer science from Galatasaray University in 2011. I published some online courses related to machine learning and cryptography on Udemy, and I have a personal blog, my name plus the first letter of my surname, sefix.com. And I published a blog posts here related to machine learning and cryptography. I strongly recommend you to visit this blog. Besides, I just use Twitter actively. You can mention my surname to ask anything. I will answer, promise. So, GBM and deep learning are the most common machine learning algorithms, and machine learning studies have big polarization. Practitioners mostly adopt either GBM or deep learning, here in my opinion. Deep learning looks like Superman because it has a self-confident and strong stance. On the other hand, GBM looks like a flash. It might not as strong as deep learning, but it's still challenged. And who is going to win this fight? We will discuss advantages and disadvantages of each algorithm unbiasedly. First of all, consider deep learning. It is the hottest topic in machine learning because it really gives us superpowers. For example, face recognition is not a hard task anymore. We can even apply it in a real time. And this example detects face from the webcam on the left side and compares the similarities in the faces on the right side. AI understands that this guy, this is me, this guy is neither CEO nor founder of Facebook, Twitter, or Google. Really intelligent, right? Moreover, we can apply emotion analysis or mood detection. This video was captured after the Cambridge Analytica scandal of Facebook, and the market value of the Facebook decreased $134 billion. This makes sad anyone, and this makes sad Zuckerberg too, I seen. Almost 80% he has sad emotion. Furthermore, this painting is Starry Night of Vincent van Gogh, and van Gogh had a specific style in his art, and this is Galatasaray University I graduated. It's located in Istanbul, Bosporus. And what if Vincent van Gogh had painted Istanbul Bosporus? Actually, deep learning can answer this question with artistic style transfer. And this is the solution. This is really art, right? Also, remember the I Know Kung Fu scene in the Matrix one? Similarly, we can have the outcomes of pre-trained networks. For example, I ask this picture on the right side to the Google's Inception version 3, and it says This is 76% as Eskimo dog. Deep learning is strong, yes, but being strong is not enough sometimes. You must be worthy to lift the hammer of Thor, for example. You might remember the Microsoft chatbot Tay. It has a deep learning technology in the background, and it becomes a racist one in hers. Then Microsoft turns it off as a solution instead of developing a patch. Actually, this is because deep learning is totally a black box, and we cannot answer variant how questions as well. For example, remember the 5W and 1H. By the way, this is the Turkish translation of 5W 1H, and this is the popular news program in Turkey. Sorry, remember the 5W and 1H? Two of these six questions cannot be answered in the deep learning. For example, why did the neural network have this number of layers or not? Or why did you set learning rate to 0.1, or more importantly, how this works? These are questions cannot be answered in deep learning, so deep learning hits the wall when decisioning matters. This is because neural networks are combinations of matrix multiplications that refers to matrix multiplication, sigmoid or real functions, real activation functions, element-wise multiplications of matrices or matrix additions, normalizations also. This is all the beyond the understanding of human beings, unfortunately. Here, GBM might be solution, GBM might be worthy for lifting the Thor's hammer, or it may move the hammer slightly, just like Captain America in the scene. Decision trees can be read and understand easily and clearly. For example, if the decision is the yellow one is to wear a rain jacket, we can read it from the decision to root. I wear a rain jacket because it's not extremely windy. But it's windy. And it's raining. Decision trees, as seen, they are explainable algorithms. This is very important in machine learning. For example, you can find the car data set here. It has six columns and 1728 rows in the data set. Decision column is the target value we would like to generalize, and the other ones are features affecting the target value. Decision trees check a feature in a level, in same level, and the most dominant feature is found and put as a decision rule. For example, here safety feature is checked. It first checks the safety feature. In an if statement, we will find the most dominant feature for the current subdata set. I mean that in safety is high block, we will find the most dominant feature for the subdata set of high safety and put a decision rule again. For example, in this block, persons, number of persons will be the most dominant feature. Similarly, just one feature can be checked in a level, as seen, just number of persons are checked in this block. I mean that I cannot check a luggage after checking persons, because it's this level is reserved by persons and this level is reserved by safety feature. And finally, the most dominant feature is based on the entropy and information gain calculations in ID3, gain ratio calculations in C4.5, Gini indexes in CART, or basic standard deviation in regression trees. I skip these steps because we would like to mention the GBM. And when ID3 algorithm is applied to CART dataset, these decision rules will be created. The right side mentions the all rules and zoomed area. It consists of 700 lines, but luckily we don't write these rules by hand. Decision tree algorithm handles it. Actually, I like this meme. It checks the username and password and some other things in the website, and so many nested if statements exist. You remember the guy in the Street Fighter? I think his name was Ryu, and it is a he has a special attack named Hadouken, and only Hadouken can format these nested if statements. But again, luckily we don't write all of those rules. Decision tree algorithm can handle it. Until now we have mentioned how decision trees work. So what kind of a classifiers they are? Actually, they are non-linear classifiers or non-linear machine learning models. For example, consider this data set and we would like to separate plus and minus characters. On the left side, a linear model draws a line like that and classify items negative up to the this line and classify positive items down to this line. But this one is not classified correctly, the green one, this one. Now but decision trees can apply these rules and classify all items correctly, as seen. Now consider this data set. Applying a linear model can classify this line. Items up to this line will be classified as minus, and items down to this line will be classified as plus. And all items will be classified as correctly. What about decision trees? Decision trees can classify all items too, but it will be hard in the previous step. In other words, decision trees can classify this kind of a data set too. Now it's time to gradient boosting machines. Actually, this poster is belong to I think the last movie of Terminator, Rise of the Machines, and I put the Rise of the Gradient of the Rise of the Gradient Boosting Machines. GBM believes that a single tree is not strong enough. Consider a golf player, and suppose that the distance distance between he and the target is 100 meters. He must swing hard to golf ball firstly. Suppose that he can push the ball 70 meters. Now he shouldn't give up and he should swing softer than the previous round because the distance is less than the first round. It's 30 meters now. Now he will push 50 meters, suppose that. And again he goes to 50 meters and swing again. And he complete a hole on the third round. This is the summary of the gradient boosting. We will build a decision tree and we will build another one based on the errors in the previous round. Predictions getting close to perfect in each round, and as seen, loss decreases in each round. That's why its name includes gradient, because it comes from gradient descent. You might be familiar with it in neural networks and deep learning. TensorFlow Playground here offers a client-side classifier, and using all input candidates as input and increasing number of nodes in the first hidden layer from 2 to 6 can classify the spiral dataset as seen. And this is very hard dataset actually to classify, and only powerful algorithms can classify this. And we have already known that deep learning is a strong machine learning model. Here, similar TensorFlow playground, similar to TensorFlow playground, a GBM implementation exists too, and you can find it here. And building 30 trees recursively, all of those trees, can classify spiral dataset too. This is very successful, actually. To sum up, a decision tree might be weaker than the deep learning, but GBM provides decision trees to come together and to become as strong as deep learning. What about GBM? Might be stronger than the deep learning. It's not a must, but Kaggle winning model owners can't explain model details. And we have the data for the 29 winning solutions in the 2015. And 17 solutions are related to GBM in 2015. Whereas 11 solutions are related to deep learning. This means that more than half of the winning solutions use GBM. Besides, 9 solutions are ensemble models. I mean that they both use GBM and deep learning. This is a very important metric too. So I try to convince you about neither GBM nor deep learning is stronger than the other. But I like to convince you about that. GBM is a very powerful machine learning algorithm. That machine learning practitioners should put it in their toolbox, and it shouldn't be ignored by anyone. Thank you for joining this webinar, and I hope you enjoyed this presentation, and hope to see you soon. Again, you can find the details of my opinions in my personal blog, cfix.com. And you can contact me on my Twitter account. Thank you for watching again, and see you next time.